Howdy all y'all, it's time for cake. I have not been that busy, but I did pen up all the dang pigs and chickens. I got real tired of them crowding in here around my pressure plate. I got real tired of them getting hung up around the base of my apothecary, and I got extremely tired of them hanging out in my mana pool. And about that mana pool, let's have a quick look there. That mana pool is at about 60%, which is pretty impressive. Now, we burned all that charcoal. There is nothing currently in there. I'm going to go ahead and I thought I made some more. Yep, I did. I'm going to go ahead and put some more in there. But we need some other way of doing this. This is just, you know, this is happening in such a fashion that things are getting, you know, I'm spending a lot of time chopping trees to feed the charcoal thing. Well, there's ways around that, but first we're gonna have to make some more tools. And the first tool we're gonna be making is we're gonna be making a runic altar. Now I'm gonna be having to create some room for this puppy, truth be told. And to do that, let's see here. Well, before I go fussing about where I'm gonna put it, let's just make the dang thing. For starters, we need that mana diamond from t'other day. Soon enough, I'm gonna need that mana steel ingot, and we're gonna need some Livingrock. And this is a very straightforward little recipe. We're just gonna take our mana diamond, and we're gonna do like an upside down minecart, and voila, we have our runic altar. And that gets us a bunch of runes. Whoop, wait, there's something else we gotta do. Uh-oh, we gotta make some runes. Well now, that's gonna possibly be a bit challenging. Alright, fair enough. The first thing we gotta do, let's see. All this thing does is every time a mana pool next to it receives mana, it gives off blue. If a mana pool next to it is losing mana, it gives off red. Which is to say, it does not do that much. Now, in order to power our runic altar, we're going to need to make another piece, another mana spreader. So, I'm going to take that, and I'm going to take some petals here. No, I don't have enough brown. I've got way too much magenta. Take some magenta petals, that's what I'll do. And I'm gonna need some gold. I got two bars. Excellent. That is what I need. So let's start out with that. Let me go ahead and do this, because man, you know we're gonna need more. You know it. So go ahead and take my gold ingots, my magenta petals, take the Livingwood, wrap it around. There's our mana spreaders. Now, I'm going to put this puppy right here. And I'm going to have to find some other place to stick that, that Daybloom. But first, let's put this here. Now, we're going to want to bind this. There we go. We can kind of see in there, there's a little bit of a green sparkle. It's aimed at this. We know it is. It's all good. So, let's see. We're going to need to make a water, an earth, and an air rune. We already got a fire rune because of a... I think that's a quest reward from earlier. Alright. Well, going to need some Livingrock. And we're going to need some other things. So let's go ahead and put that there. And let's go have a look at runes. That's under basic stuff, crazy enough. So we'll look at our runic altar here. There's our recipe for that. And runes are where everything is. So water rune, we're going to need some sugar cane. I got that. Going to need some bone meal. And we are gonna need a fishing rod as well as three manasteel. earth, 3 more Manasteel. Y'all detecting kind of a theme here? Block of coal. Uh-oh, I'm going to have to do some digging. And I think air, yeah. Carpet, feather, and some string. Man, I don't think I got enough string to pull that off. I got 4 string. It's not enough to make carpet with. And I don't have that much iron either. Well, I do over here. I just didn't want to... I don't know, man. You know, you get into that habit of ore doubling and you start saving all your ore up for that day that you get the ore doubler to work. But I'm not ore doubling right now, am I? Oh, look at how quick it went through that. I put in a stack. We're already down to 23. On the other hand, pool is filling up. Okay, so let's get that in there. Get that in there. And I will take the iron that's already here. And I'm going to chuck all 8 of these into the mana pool. And now I've got 9 mana steel ingots. Okay. So let's look at that again. String, carpet. This one we can't do till I knock off some more sheep or some more spiders, one or t'other. I need some coal for that one. But this one, I got sugar cane. I just need to make a fishing rod. Of course, that's going to use up some string, but it's going to show you how this all works. So let's take that. Let's go ahead and take some wood. Make ourselves a couple of sticks. There's our fishing rod. Okay. Put that back so we'll get some more string. I have not been fortunate enough to have sheep appear on any of my things. I got some chickens here. I got chickens and a cow. I got pigs, but no sheep. No sheep at all. So that's going to be an issue. Howsomever, let's put you down. Where can I put you down? That'll do. And this thing, well, I don't really need it, but... There. Alright, so the way this works is whatever we're going to put in the runic altar, we want to put it in there one piece at a time. You just right click, it starts floating up above. If you want to take something out, you need to shift right click, but you need to do it with an empty hand. Well, we know we're going to need 3 of them. And the next thing we are going to need is a fishing rod. Whoops, come on, fishing rod. There we go. And now we need some sugar cane. I got that. And what was the other thing we needed? Let's see. Sugar cane, fishing rod, bone meal. Easy peasy. Got plenty of bone meal. Okay. Now these do not have to be in some particular order, fortunately. So there's our bone meal. And there is our sugar cane. Now we take the wand. We click on the altar. And now you may notice there's this little timer kind of thing going, and it shows us the ruin of water, which is what we're making. And when it's done with this, it's going to kind of start hucking lightning around. When that happens, we're going to want to chuck one piece of living stone on top. Here we go. There's our lightning. Now we know it's live. So I'm gonna, there's our thing. And now, whoops, we got to chuck that down and then hit it with a wand. Whoop, that doesn't help. Making a mess here. All right. Wand on 3. Okay. 4, 3, boom. Okay. And we have earned an achievement, Lilium Doll. I have no idea what that means. But we have 3 runes of water, so that worked. That worked out quite well. I'm going to go ahead and put the runes of water over here. And we're going to need to figure out a way to get some string. So let me see if there are some means of getting string in here that aren't the norm. if you will. Well, we can craft cotton if we find any. That's nice. Chemistry set. Nope. Mana infusion, but we need an alchemy catalyst. Well, that's going to be a while, because an alchemy catalyst needs brewing stands. Brewing stands means a trip to the Nether. So, that's going to be a bit. But those are our only options. It's that, or it's kill spiders. And you notice with all this purple slime, not a lot of spiders out here. Or it's, you know, I'm going to be honest here. I'm halfway tempted just to go and do the Nether thing. Let me see here. What would it take me? Well, it would take me 8 obsidian is what it would take me. I do not currently have a diamond pick. My armor doesn't suck. Do I really want to give that a shot? Well, tell you what we're going to do. We are going to build a Nether portal without a diamond pick. And to do that, we are going to be bucketing up a lot of lava. Actually, let me clear out some space before I do all this. Pardon me, fellas. Okay. What I mean by clear out some space is I got milk over here, I got water over here. I'm going to go ahead and take this milk out. And I'm going to turn it into fresh milk using Harvest Craft to get my bucket back. And that will be useful later. But I need the bucket right now. So let's get our bucket back on 3. Oops. I can do this thing. Off we go. And I know there's some lava this way. So here we go. Lava quest. Where are you? Ooh, bright node. Those aren't too common. And they're very useful. I really should kind of get myself a sort of a map of what sort of nodes I've got around here and where they're at. Just so I can more easily figure. Huh. Okay, you know what? Whoops, where'd you go? Okay, I've already done that for a slime. I don't need to do it again. Well, if I kill you, you might drop loot. Where are you? Okay. Well, that didn't seem too terribly like much. Nope. Alright. Waste of time, waste of slime. But right over there, we can see light shining on the underside of that tree. And we know why that is. That is because lava. So up we go. And unfortunately, oh, there's our lava. Stand right here and not get bit, I hope. We already checked that out. Okay, can we reach from here? Yes, we can. Okay, so I open up the pack, put lava in there. Whoop, it's not the pack. I gotta remember to hit B. It's important. This is a very shallow lava pool here. That's all right. I'm fine with that. That means that I can fill it in more easily once I'm done with this, and I'll be able to reduce the lag it's generating because of all this lava trying to flow in on itself. And, you know, I'm actually going to try and do that right now by digging up some of this rather nasty tainted dirt that I'm standing on and putting it in there. And that way, I will not have this difficulty. Okay, so let's see. One there, one there, one there. And also one here. And one there. Forgot to get that one. Alright, well, easy enough to fix. Awesome. Alright. I hate it when it does this, but it doesn't matter. I'm not headed that direction. So now we just head back to base and attempt not to die due to taint and taint creepers and all the lovely gloriousness that goes with living in a purple world. Okay, not too shabby, not too shabby. Now, the problem here, of course, is that I've only got 5 buckets, and those of you in the know are going to realize that I'm going to need more than that. Well, it's a start. It's exactly half of what I need, so it'll have to do, as it were. Now, I'm actually not going to set this thing up inside. I'm going to set this thing up outside. Because I really, you know, number one, space is kind of a critical thing for me in here. Number two, I do not particularly have a fondness for the noise that nether portals make. Yay. Should have known that was coming. Just gotta wear it down. Okay. I'm gonna put that in there. And I'm gonna put that in there. And let's get our first bucket of lava going. Didn't predict that. There we go. Alright, there's our first piece of obsidian. To make my life a tiny bit easier, I'm just going to put that right there. And we're going to get ourselves another bucket of lava. Put that in there. Y'all can see which way the wind is blowing here. It's pretty straightforward. Except I just ruined my lava, because I'm an idiot. Alright. Well, that's going to mean... No, that is not going to mean another trip. I do not need to make another trip because I have 2 buckets, I'm pretty sure. So I will, next time I will just make 1 trip, but I will come home with 1 bucket more lava than I did this time. There we go. That's what I meant to do. This takes a little bit of time and a little bit of labor, but y'all can see how it works. It's pretty straightforward if you've never done it before. Little more lava, and there's our water, and there's our obsidian. And we're gonna need to dig that out. And grab our last bucket of lava. I don't know why I'm putting the corners in. It's making more work for me. It's using up more obsidian and more lava. I ain't playing this as smart as I could be. That's my problem right this second. Okay, well, you know what? We can fix that. Thought I had another bucket. I guess I don't have another bucket. Okay. Easy solution. We are gonna take that out. Put it in there. And with that done, now I can carry 8 buckets. In one trip. And that is just enough to finish this out if I am not stupid and wasteful by putting stuff in the corners when it doesn't need to be there. So we'll see how that goes. It looks like, whoa, hello. Didn't realize that was a throughway. It looks as though I'm going to be able to... Wow. That's pretty serious back there. I'm going to be able to just finish this up for this particular bit of work here. And I'm probably not going to be able to get too much more done with the runic altar itself. I'm doing this because I want to be able to reduce the lag, therefore I am filling in lava as I take it out. Okay. Moving a little quicker now that we've kind of got the rhythm of it. That's good. Still, though, if I'd planned ahead, wouldn't be having to do this at all. Gives me 8, and just in case I do something stupid, because, yeah, well, hell, y'all know me, just in case, I'm going to grab myself one more bucket of lava here. Alright, and my hunger is kind of being a problem, so let's get that taken care of so we can top off our health. Excellent. And back we go. Let's not go ahead and take that shortcut. Hello, Mr. Creeper. Let's see, what the heck else is over here? My radar is showing stuff. It must be underground, because I sure don't see it up here. Howsomever, it does appear to be following me underground, or at least it briefly tried to. Now, this should finish up our portal. Assuming I don't do something stupid. And, well, we know the odds of that happening, right? Right. The other thing to bear in mind here is that if there is taint on top of any part of our portal when we try to torch it off, it is not going to actually do its thing. So that's something we need to kind of bear in mind. Okay, there's our first bucket of lava. And there go. There for the moment. And our second bucket of lava. That was predictable. I'm just using this dirt as a quick and easy kind of molding material. Good. I was a little concerned I might not be able to reach it. That would have been annoying. Okay, getting the hang of that. Let's turn our coin on. Okay. To hold it for a second or two. Good. Okay. Now let's see here. That didn't work quite the way I'd hoped. Put you up there. Alrighty, making it happen, it's all downhill from here. Man, I really did screw that thing up. Okay, well, we can fix it later. Now is not the time. That was an absolutely useless little mistake right there. Okay. And where's our lava? There's our lava. I sound awake to you? Because I'm not acting awake to me. Alright, one to go. There. Okay. And we are done. All we need now is flint and steel, and I do believe I can manage that. Maybe not. Did I use up all my flint making arrows? Oh, for the love of Pete. I think I did. Oh, nice. Real nice. Okay, well, got some gravel. Let's see if we get lucky. Hey, look, it's flint. Alright. There's our flint and steel. Ta-da. Tra-la. Now, I'm being a little bit, perhaps, foolish in how I go about this. Because the truth is that the Nether is no easy place to be here. But hey, you know, we'll see what we get. There we go. We have us a portal. Now, let's do a tiny bit of prep here. For starters, let's drop the things we do not need. We're not going to need that neither, but I don't want to put it in there. Let's put you here, and here, and here. Ugh. Okay. Things don't necessarily want to die and lose in the Nether. Alright, I got my pickaxe, I got flint and steel, torches. Let's put you there. Actually, let's put you there. Carrots are not the best possible option we could use. Let's, let's take, I thought I had some wheat. I did have some wheat. Alright, real quick, like, let's make some bread. Horrible, inefficient way to do it, but let's do it that way. Yay, I can bake. Hooray me. Okay. Nope. Alright, fellas. Actually, I'm going to use carrots there. Just to top off. And then I'm going to leave them here, because I don't particularly want to run out of carrots. I need to grow some. Come to think of it, I should check on them taters. They look like they're doing pretty well over there. But not just this second. Let's just go ahead and let's wrap this episode up by one quick look around the Nether and see how bad it is. The answer? It's going to be pretty bad, I'd say. Well, here we go. Any second now. Okay. Let's not catch fire immediately on coming through the gate. What the hell was that? Well, this is not so bad. We're in a kind of a little cave system. There's some gold ore. There's some nether quartz. Nothing has exploded in my face yet. I like that. This is not so... Whoops. Guess it wasn't finished drawing. There's a lot of gold ore here. Well, can we get out of this? That's looking promising. Nope. It's promising, but it lies. Oh. Are you real? You're not real. What the heck? Oh, for the love of Pete. I'm stuck in a cave. stuck in a hole. Alright, there is nothing moving on my radar. What's my altitude? 106. Oh, hi there. Are you way out? Not even a little bit. Oh, there's some ore of some kind. Nether coal. Hello. Man. This is getting to be quite a trip just to try to find an open expanse here. Okay, I need a marker. Let's try this direction. Gold, mushroom. Are you a dead end? I don't know. Yeah, you're a dead end. Huh. Well, I mean, I don't have 10 ghasts bombing me at once. I suppose that's a good thing. You a dead end? Don't know. Time to set up more markers here. Goodness gracious, this is the most, I don't know how to say. This is the most, what's that word for folks that hate to be in tight places? Claustrophobic nether I've ever seen. It is just, there is no openings. There is no... On the other hand, nothing's blown up at me yet. Is that all the directions I can go? Dang. What the hell? Okay, both of them go back the way I came. That all goes over here. Wow. Aw, man. I can kind of see kind of a map, I mean. On my mini map, at least, I can. And it looks like there's something over this way, but I don't know how far. That dead end's down here, pretty sure. Yeah. No fun. No joy. And then this here is this big kind of loop. And it goes way the hell over here. Oh, hello. Piggies. Piggies suggest to me that there's an open space back that way. I don't have any rock. I don't have any real rock. I can't do no more mining. Well, I can break stuff, but... Okay, maybe it's up to get into that? Is that lava? I can't tell what that is. I hope it isn't lava. Well, okie doke, let's try this then. Hello. We found something. I hear lava. I'm pretty sure I do.
tail. Okay, let's see. That is glowstone. That's nice. Problem here is that in order for me to get what I came for, I need to find an open space. I believe that this particular nether has like weird biomes and stuff, but I could be wrong. Okay, let's light this up. And as much as we can, light it up. Okay. And that's going to take us back over this way. There's piggy. Hello, piggies. Are you hostile? Please do not be hostile. You're between me and my home. I'm going to leave now. Excuse me, nothing to see here. Just wandering through. Nothing to see here. Okay. Where's my damn portal? There it is. Okay. Alright, fellas. That concludes today. It's been 40-some minutes. We got our altar made. Let's check one last thing over here, because I think I saw those potatoes look ready. Those potatoes are ready. Look at that. Okay, let's put one of them in here. Hey, we got two potatoes out of it. That's a big deal. Uh-oh, why aren't we... Ah, potato seed, that's what we want. Growth 4, gain 4. So we're getting somewhere with them. Good. Unidentified. There we are. Growth 4, gain 4. Let's replant them. Okay, and the wheat is coming along pretty nice. Yeah, most of these are just junk. And I'm just going to dump them over here. Whoa! Hi there. How did you get into such a mess? Damn it. Okay, that's the problem with the stupid coin thing. Okay, how'd he get out and get himself all met? Oh, that's how. Alright, I can't let that tree hang out there. Alright, folks. I'm going to go ahead and take care of business here. And I appreciate y'all stopping by. I hope you have enjoyed this. Although we did not get nearly as much accomplished as I hoped we would. I do appreciate it. You all have a good one, and tell your friends. Cake's good for you. I'll see you next time, and we'll get some more runes done and get that altar working. Have a good one.